We're Jake and Tatina, and these are our pups, Joey and Charlie. We love exploring the world in our backyard, but we're also balancing two full-time jobs. We're dreaming of a day when we can travel full-time, and until then, we're fitting in as much as we can outside of work. Join us every second Friday as we share our adventures and daily lives. Subscribe and come with us for the ride. We are 3 days into our road trip through the Canadian Rockies, and we've been traveling and living out of our trailer with our two dogs. If you haven't seen our last episode, go check it out. Today, we're doing some hiking in the Mount Revelstoke National Park, and after that, we're driving across the border to Alberta! Morning, we are getting ready to go on our hike in the Meadows in the Sky Parkway. It's about a 4 hour hike round trip, but first we're tiring out the doggos so that they can have a little rest in the trailer while mom and dad are hiking.
So when we leave the dogs back at the trailer, we leave the AC on, we give them a bone, and we have a camera that connects to the Wi-Fi. Then we can wirelessly access anywhere and move around the camera. We can go side to side, pan it up and down, so we can look at the dogs, make sure they're okay. We can turn it around to look at our thermostat to make sure it's nice and cool in there and not too hot.
All right, let's head out. Most expensive part of the trip, definitely the gas. Anyone is wondering why Charlie and Joey are not with us? Dogs are prohibited. They're not allowed because of the wildlife. There have been a lot of run-ins with dogs off leash and bears in this park. So I think it was June of last year actually where they brought in this rule that dogs are not allowed past the 12 kilometer mark. Sad, but oh well. So about 6 kilometers down the road from where we were supposed to start our hike, we met a Canada Parks ranger who told us that the rest of the road was closed because of the snow. So we had to park the truck and walk the rest of the way up to get to our hike, and oh man, was it ever hot. We were walking on the pavement in the middle of the BC heat wave. I'm talking 35 to 40 degrees Celsius temperatures. That being said, we knew what we were getting ourselves into and we weren't about to turn back now. I don't know if you can even see it in the video, but I have beads of sweat dripping down my face. It's like a very low incline, low and slow incline, but oh man, is it ever hot.
It's just pavement in the smoking hot sun.
Yeah.
We're supposed to get to a trail soon.
Yes, and a lake.
Yeah. Love is love. Love is love. Adios. Kilometers an hour.
Whoa, slow down, sir.
Side of Mount Revelstoke, and Tatina is checking on the dogs.
It's 20 degrees in there, they're good.
From here, we go down to a forest trail to hopefully find a lake.
If Jake's directions are correct.
Well, as a millennial who uses Google Maps for everything, I'm sure my paper map reading skills are to the highest standard.
Jacob, what just happened here?
We thought we were going towards the lake and then the lookout point we wanted to check out, and we went the wrong way for about 20 minutes. So we went back down a trail. So now we gotta backtrack 20 minutes and then go up. We went down the wrong trail.
We're getting our steps in today at least. Big workout. So Jake, remember when you said that as millennials, reading maps, is it your strong suit? I think you're right.
All right, so we made our way to the proper route to the summit and to the lake.
How did that feel coming back up?
go up that way about 35 more minutes. We'll hit the summit.
And we passed by the Balsam Lake. We thought, you know, we could come back to it if we feel like it.
There's some movement in the bushes.
Some kind of gopher or something.
You'll probably see us again at the summit.
All right. So here is where we are. There's a little lookout over here, which is called the Fire Lookout Trail. So we are going to go check that out. It's about 10 minutes away. I'm kind of bummed because I really, really, really wanted to go to Miller Lake and even hit up Eva Lake, but those are 2 to 3 hours away. I will just have to enjoy the views at the Fire Lookout Trail and enjoy the views of Eva Lake on Google. Okay, now we have officially reached the summit.
6,360 feet up.
Woo!
We're at the summit of Mount Revelstoke. Let's go. All to ourselves. So they're opening it up tomorrow, so you can park up by this lake. But today's the last day that you have to walk up 6 kilometers up the hot road. So we got this all to ourselves. Yeah. We're gonna enjoy it. Times it feels nice after all that heat. It is a glacier lake though, it's freezing.
We are out of the lake. Jake put his head under. He has a little bit of a headache, so he's laying down right behind me. This lake is so beautiful. There is snowy banks, beautiful trees. It's like 36 degrees. The water is so nice and cool and refreshing, and it's so quiet. It's so peaceful. All right, we are on our way back down. It's a lot nicer than walking up here. We are very excited to get back to our air-conditioned trailer and change our clothes. But that lake dip was really, really nice. Just perfect before I walk down here. So we will see you down at the bottom.
We found the truck.
Hooray!
Finally.
We are both very, very, very tired. But we still have to go to the grocery store. We've got to grab something to eat. Something to drink right now would be really good also.
Yeah, we need to get some change. We're gonna use the laundry facilities at the RV park tonight.
Yeah, do some
after
laundry.
Our nap probably.
Yes. And then that's about it, right? And then
yeah,
we're
same
just
for
gonna
tonight.
Hang out at the campsite tonight.
Maybe we'll watch a movie or something.
Yeah. Alright, we'll see you guys back at the campsite. That is crazy hair. So we made it back to the trailer. We were so tired. I think we came back at around 7:30, fell asleep for an hour and a bit. Jake was feeling a little bit sick, but after he laid down for a bit, he felt better. At around 9, we got up and started making some dinner. We had picked up some prepackaged pasta and just some pasta sauce. A really quick and easy dinner, but we are full now. We're feeling much better. And Jake's just off doing laundry. There's a washer and dryer on site. It's just like a coin laundry area. And I'm just gonna go and clean the kitchen. We're gonna cross over from BC to Alberta tomorrow, which I'm really excited for. We're gonna see an old friend, do a barbecue with him. We'll see what else the day brings us tomorrow. We don't really have any other plans. Quick note before I get to cleaning the kitchen. I'm gonna show you the map of where we went. This is a good little view here. We started down here off the highway. We drove all the way through these winding roads. No dogs beyond this point. That's why we didn't bring the boys. All the way up to, I think just around here was where the road closure was. We parked the truck here and then we started walking up the road. And then the road comes over here from the parking area here all the way up to this parking lot right here. That took us 6 kilometers. And it was at this point here, Jake looked at the map and he thought that this was the way to the summit trail, which is fair. I mean, it's called the summit trail, but it's for people walking up to the summit and not using the road. So we accidentally went down that way. That was an extra kilometer. We walked up here after that. So usually you would park down here and there's some kind of shuttle that would take you up this road, and then you could start doing all of these hikes. This was another kilometer that we did. I wanted to really go to Eva Lake and Miller Lake and the Jade Lakes, which only would have been 2 to 3 hours, 2 to 4 hours maybe from this parking lot here, but I didn't know that the road was closed, so we had already walked for about 3 to 4 hours to get here, so going further just wasn't an option. Next time we came back down, we walked over to the Balsam Lake. We ended up walking for just around, was it 16 kilometers? It was really hot, especially walking on the road, on the pavement. There was no cover above us, no trees. We were sweating like crazy. We took a lot of water breaks. We really only saw maybe 2-3 groups of people. I can only imagine how busy it would have been if that parking lot on the upper summit area was open and the road was open. So I think it worked out for the best and it was a lot of fun. Anyways, I'm gonna do the dishes now.
Good morning, everyone.
We are heading to Calgary today. This will be the longest drive of our entire trip. It'll probably take us around 5 hours. I think Google Maps says 4, but usually with the trailer, it takes us about another hour. And we'll probably do one stop in the middle at a rest stop.
So we don't have a lot of time, but I'm gonna throw together a couple breakfast sandwiches with the eggs and the vegan bacon we have. And hopefully we can eat those on the road.
Any big trip, I always go around the truck and the trailer and check all the tire pressure of all 8 tires. About an hour into our drive, we're in Glacier right now and we're on our way to Calgary. It's about another 3.5 hour drive until we're there. Just a little over 2 hours to go. We're at a rest stop just past Golden, BC. I'm pretty sure we'll be entering Alberta pretty soon.
Well, we made it to Alberta. We are officially in the beautiful province of Alberta.
Alright, so we made it. We are in Calgary at the Callaway RV Park. Tatina's just checking in, and then we're gonna find our spot, hook up, and then we're gonna go visit some friends in Calgary. Probably won't be videoing a lot of that or any of that, and then we'll be back, and tomorrow we're going to Banff.
Later that night, while we were coming back from our friend's place, we ran into a thunderstorm. Luckily not right in our area, but close enough that we could see its beauty on our drive home.
Alright, so we're back in the trailer after visiting some old friends. And we're gonna crash now. Tomorrow morning we're heading up to Banff in Lake Louise, check all that out. So excited for that, but really tired after today. It was about 6 hours of driving from Revelstoke to Calgary. And then an hour out to see our friend, about an hour round trip. Yeah. And yeah, we're pretty exhausted, so we're gonna hit the hay. Night.
Thanks for watching this episode, you guys. Next video, we're going to be showing you the spectacular views of Banff from a mountaintop. Before you leave today, remember to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it and hit that subscribe button. We would love to see your face around here more often. We'll see you next time. Is he dead? I don't know what's going on here.
Oh, there he is. Okay.
Feels nice.